Hi, I'm Johannes, product owner at Tesla. And in this tutorial, I'm gonna show you how you create and configure the Modbus TCP sensor to monitor a bunch of devices like PLCs, energy meters, UPS systems, and many, many more. Have fun. So let's start right away monitoring our robot using the Modbus TCP sensor. First, we're gonna add the sensor as usual using the add sensor dialog. We type Modbus, and here we have it, the Modbus TCP custom monitors values returned by Modbus TCP server, and currently you're able to monitor up to 5 values using that sensor. So let's start and call it robot status. As usual in the Modbus TCP field, you need to specify a port. In our case, it's 13502. You need to specify a unit ID. Usually it can stay 1, but if you're using Modbus RTU devices behind the Modbus TCP gateway, you should consider changing the unit ID to the proper device you want to connect behind the gateway. Also, if you need to change the byte order, PRTG supports big endian, little endian, and byte swap both ways. So if you have a proper device, check the manual and then select the byte order you need for your device. Okay, let's start. Channel number 1. Here we're gonna check the CPU temperature of our robot. And the register type is in this case a holding register. We support all 4 types: coil, discrete input, input register, and holding register. If you select coil and discrete input, we will convert it automatically to a Boolean variable, basically. So our case CPU temperature is the register number 10. And in our case, it's a 16-bit integer, so we read only 1 register. If you have a bigger number, then of course select the 32-bit integer or whatever you need. And in our case, PRTG automatically reads as much registers as needed to cover the byte. So for example, in a 16-bit integer, we read 1 register. If you select a 32-bit integer number, we will read 2 registers and so forth. Just as a reminder. The unit in our case is degrees Celsius, as we are monitoring the temperature of the CPU. Second channel is the CPU load of our robot. And in this case, it's also a holding register, and it's the next register to the CPU, which is then register number 11. You can find the register numbers in the manual of your device, and also which kind of data is in there. And it's also a 16-bit integer number, and here we have percentage. The third channel we're gonna add is an alert channel, which is used by our device to signal an alert on the device. It's a coil, which means, as I said before, it's a Boolean representation, so it can be either on or off. In our case, it's an alert or it's not an alert. We select coil, and the register number here is 3. And the last channel we're gonna add is the fan RPM. So our robot has 1 fan, and we want to monitor the RPM of it. It's an input register, and it's the number 5. And again, it's a 16-bit integer number. Unit is RPM. Okay, let's have a check. Everything is filled. We have a proper name. We specified the port. We selected the byte order. And we have up to 4 channels. So let's add the sensor. Short refresh. And as you can see now, we have all the metrics in the sensor we wanted. So we have the CPU temperature, which is currently 24 degrees Celsius. We have the CPU load with 1%. We have the alert channel, and as I said, now we have it on off. So there is no alert currently on the device, and we have the fan speed with 10,000 RPMs. So we can, as usual, define a threshold if needed. So in the temperature field, we can say if it's above 50, we want to get a warning. If it's above 70 degrees, we want to get an alert. CPU is getting too hot. And as you can see, we have already the representation visible. The same applies for coil and discrete input. As I said, if it's automatically converted to a Boolean flag, and you can specify the lookup directly. So we hand out a default lookup, which you can find as usual in the folder, Tesla Modbus lookup Boolean. Here we have 0 is off and 1 is on, but you can change it anytime to your own preferences, so you get a proper alert if needed. And that's basically it and everything you need to know to set up the Modbus TCP sensor. I hope you really found this tutorial helpful, and if so, please give us a like or consider subscribing to our YouTube channel. Also, leave us a comment for feedback or any other topics. And if there are any questions, always ask us at support@pesla.com. Thanks for watching.